Hey, good morning, Math 7 students. Here is what we got today. I'm only having you do one con today. I do not want you using a calculator for this one. I want to make sure you can do this one by hand. If you can, that's fantastic. So what you're doing is converting fractions. So for example, we're going to convert this fraction into a decimal. And I want you to know how to do this by hand. As soon as we get good at that, then after this, I don't care if you use a calculator, but for this one, I want you to do it by hand. So to do this, the denominator always goes on the outside. Oh, and you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to do one more little thing here. What is it I'm going to do? Oh, hold on. Give me a moment. You can watch me kind of live. And we're going to do a white. No, let's do a gray on gray. Gray on gray. Perfect. And we are going to do gray on gray, like that. And then we're gonna do one over here too. So gray on gray, boom, all right. So what we do is we put the 5 on the outside of the fraction here and the 57 on the inside of the fraction. Well, wait, Ms. Jamson, this number is 57, not 57.000. Well, I get that. But when you're dividing this, because you probably noticed 5 doesn't go into 57 perfectly. So I'm going to add a decimal after the 57 and a bunch of zeros, because zeros after a decimal do not change the number. This is still just 57, but it allows us to do some dividing. So step number one is we want to see how many times does 5 go into the first number. Well, 5 goes into 5. Would you all say one time? Yeah. And then we're going to subtract that. So we're going to take that 5. 5 times 1 is 5, so that goes here. And 5 minus 5 is 0, I hope you say. Except we also have the 7, so we're going to bring down the 7. And we're going to have a 7 right there. Okay, so 57 minus that 5, or 5 minus 5 is 0. Bring down the 7. That's kind of what we're doing there. Then, after we bring the 7 down, how many times does 5 go into 7? Hope you're going, well, 5 only goes into 7 one time, and you'd be correct. It goes in one time. And 5 times 1 right there, 5 times 1 is 5. So 7 minus 5 is 2. 2, well, 2. Okay, well, where'd the 0 come from, Mr. Anderson? Well, here's the deal. 5 doesn't go into 2. So pretend for a moment that 0 is not there. Sorry about that. 7 minus 5 is 2. 5 doesn't go into 2, so you're probably going, well, what do we do there? We have a remainder of 2. Well, I want you to convert that to a decimal. In order to do that, we have to keep going, meaning I'm going to take this first 0 that I added in here, and I'm going to bring it down. Okay, I'm going to bring it down here. So now that makes it 20. And we can go, how many times does 5 go into 20? Oh, well, 5 times 4 is 20, so it could literally go in 4 times. So we put a decimal, we carry that decimal straight up, and we bring in, it goes in 4 times, so 11.4 times. Then 20 minus 20 is 0, and that's our goal. If we can get this thing to read 0, that's what we want. And then we're all done. As soon as it reads 0 down here at the end, we are done. So our answer up here would be 11.4. Okay. Ms. Jansen, I don't totally get that. Can we do one more? Sure. Let's do one more. Let's do this one over here. We've got 10 over 3. So again, the 3 goes on the outside of that, and the 10 goes on the inside. Well, there's those doggone .000. I just always suggest you add 3 zeros, and you'll kind of see why on this one. Okay, so 3 goes into 1. 3, Mr. Anderson, 3 doesn't go into 1. What do we do then? Well, then we're going to go, how many times does 3 go into 10? Oh, I see. 3 goes into 10 3 times. Okay, so 3 goes into 10 3 times. And 3 times 3 is 9. So we're going to subtract 9 from 10. Well, what is 10 take away 9? Well, it's 1, Mr. Anderson. Yeah, you're right. Oh, doggone it. Here, I'm using this one. There we go. It's a 1. Okay, that's correct. So it's 1. But, so we got to keep dividing. So what do? We're going to bring down one of these zeros we had here. We're going to bring down this first zero, which is there, right there. So now it looks like a 10 again. How many times does 3 go into 10? Oh, that's 3 times. So we go the 0.3, and 3 times 3 is 9, and 10 minus 9 is what? What is 10 minus 9? 1. Yeah, I know I got that little 0 there. Oh, shoot. We didn't get a 0 like we need. So we're going to bring down another 0. So we have another 10. And 3 goes into 10. How many times 3 goes into 10? 3 times. And 3 times 3 is 9. So bring down another 9. Cool. Okay. And then we go, okay, well, then 10 minus 9 is 1. Have you noticed we keep getting 1 and 1 and 1? And, like, this is never going to stop. This is never going to stop. We can bring down another 0, but then it's going to be 9 again, and it's just going to continue. Oopsie, what am I trying to do there? It's going to continue going on forever and ever. It's going to be another 3, and so on and so on and so on forever and ever and ever. Do you notice how that 3 keeps repeating? It's called a repeating decimal. When that happens, when we have a repeating decimal, we take whatever number is being repeated. In this case, it's the 3 over and over and over again. And after the decimal, it has to break the decimal in first. Then after the decimal, you put a repeating sign over all the numbers that are repeating. And in this case, it's just the 3 that's repeating. So your answer for this one should be 3.3 with a repeating symbol above it, which happens to be on here, letter D. So I could put a nice little circle. Let's color in our circle. What color did you want today? Oh, you wanted blue with a red fill. So right there. Oh, I guess I did a square, not a circle. That's kind of fun too. So letter D is our answer for that one. Hey, that's how you do them today, guys. This is your one con to do today. Good luck to you. And we'll see you during office hours and during class. Bye-bye.